Hello everybody, in this video lecture we will cover female reproductive system. So this is chapter 27 and I divided this PowerPoint into two parts. So that's the first lecture and it will be a second lecture on the reproductive system female. So organs of the female reproductive system will include female gonads, that are ovaries, and their function is to produce female gametes, that are ova. And another function is to secrete female sex hormones, estrogen and progesterone. Also, organs will include external genitalia, right here, and external genitalia we will cover in the second part of this lecture. In this part we will cover internal genitalia. Internal genitalia of a female located in a pelvic cavity and include ovaries and duct system such as uterine tubes, uterus and vagina. On this diagram, you can see mid-sagittal section of the human female, specifically reproductive system. You'll see external genitalia over here, vagina, uterus, uterine tube, or it used to be called fallopian tubes, and ovary, shown here in white color. Also, you can see that vagina and uterus, they are posterior to urethra and urinary bladder and anterior to the rectum. Each ovary is held in place by several ligaments. Ovarian ligament is one of these ligaments and it anchors ovary medially to uterus. Suspensory ligament and mesovarium are part of broad ligament that support uterine tubes, uterus, and vagina. So on this diagram you can see the vagina, uterus, and ovary here shown in white, and this bluish membrane, that's different ligaments over here. So the one that we just discussed was ovarian ligament and it attaches ovary to the wall of the uterus. Also, this ligament over here is called mesovarium and this is mesometrium. This is part of bigger ligament that is called broad ligament. Blood supply for ovaries, ovarian arteries, and ovarian branch of the uterine arteries. Vessels travel through suspensory ligament and mesovaria. So if you look over here, that's aorta, and that's a branch from aorta that is called ovarian artery. We have right and left ovarian artery. And it travels through this suspensory ligament and supply ovary with blood. And if you move down the aorta, this is common iliac and this branch is internal iliac. And from internal iliac, we have uterine artery, this one, uterine artery, that will have a branch that also supply ovary with the blood. Also from internal iliac artery, we have vaginal artery that supply vagina with the blood. Each ovary surrounded by fibrous tunica albuginea, which is then covered by germinal cuboidal epithelium outer layer. And this germinal cuboidal epithelium continues with peritoneum. So over here you see the histological slide of an ovary and the most superficial layer, this is the germinal cuboidal epithelium and deep to it is tunica albuginea. And you remember, we also have tunica albuginea covering testes. That's this white color tunics that give testes, or at least on the diagram we saw it, this white appearance. In ovaries, we have two fully defined regions, outer cortex, so all this part where you see different follicles, it's all cortex, and medulla in the middle, and medulla contains large blood vessels and nerves, and in the cortex you will find forming gametes. Ovarian follicles that are located inside the cortex, they contain immature egg, right, or oocyte, so that's an our oocyte, and it's surrounded by follicle cells and granulosa cells. Right, so here we will have a follicle cells, granulosa cells, and then we have some cells that's called theca, theca externa and interna. So follicles go through several stages of development. So look at this diagram. On this diagram, you see ovary, medulla is inside, cortex is on outside. And inside the cortex, you see the structures, and they all look a little bit different, right? So this is ovarian follicles. Don't confuse with hair follicles, that's different stuff, right? Ovarian follicles, it's like a little pockets, and what is inside them is ovum or egg cell. It's not developed yet, right? But that's, we call it oocyte, because it's not mature ovum yet. So we have this oocyte that will mature into ovum, and hopefully will be fertilized and became embryo and fetus and a baby. But right now, this is undeveloped eggs, and we call them oocytes. So they're shown here in yellow color, right? Right here. But what's surrounding them, the pink color, that's the follicle wall of the follicle, right? So if I draw the follicle, right, so here's a follicle, and the wall of follicle made from cells. So here one cell, is another cell, and another cell, right? So let me kind of get a couple more cells, and that's a nucleus of those cells. So you see it's one layer of cells making a follicle, and we call it follicle cells. And what we need inside? Inside we need oocytes. So I need oocyte inside, right? So it's immature egg. So if I draw follicle like this, this will be my primordial follicle, right? Females are born with this primordial follicle. Then what's gonna happen? This oocyte will change, it mature, and this follicular wall gonna change. So instead of flat cells, they became cuboidal cells. Then we grow many layers of these cells. And when these cells changing, we don't call them follicle cells anymore, we call them granulosa cells. And inside we have oocyte. And now if you see what's happening with this follicle, it starts having this, what we call antrum. That's a space filled with fluid. And so it's growing bigger and bigger. And then this process over here, number four, is ovulation. Right, so the oocyte, right, the oocyte is ovulated inside the pelvic cavity, but this granulosa cells that make wall of the follicle stays inside the ovary, and they turned into this yellow body that we call corpus luteum. Corpus means body, luteum means yellow, right? And then it regresses. And then new follicles start growing and developing. And every month, this process just repeats. So here's our vesicula or antral or tertiary follicle. This is fully mature follicle. And it has antrum filled with fluid. And this follicle bulges from ovary surface. And when it's mature, inside we have oocyte, and oocyte is ejected from this ripening follicle. That's what ovulation is. Now, whatever is left from follicle now is corpus luteum, and it develops from ruptured follicle after ovulation. So this is histological slide. You can see the germinal layer, tunica albuginea, deep to it, cortex, medulla is just this part, and follicles in the cortex at different stages of their development. Now, female duct system. Uterine tube system does not have direct contact with ovaries. I will show you what does it mean on the next slide. Ovulated oocyte is cast into peritoneal cavity, where some oocytes never make it to tube system. Right, so the oocytes are produced inside the ovaries. Then they cast or erupted, right, ejected into peritoneal cavity. Some of them will go inside these tubes. Some will never do it. But this tube system includes uterine tubes, uterus, and vagina. Now look at this picture, and that's a really like cartoon picture, but it gives you good representation of the structure. So that's uterus over here, right? So that's the uterus, and this structure, this is called uterine tube or fallopian tube. And uterine tube, it has different parts, but that's an ovary. And this line over here, this is like a rope. That's a uterine ligament. So you can see the ovary doesn't have direct connection with tubes. So when, let's say, oocyte is ovulated, here's the oocyte, right? Right here, it's ovulated inside the peritoneal cavity. Here's another one, right? Maybe two was ovulated. Well, they might never get inside this tube, but maybe one, maybe this is a bigger one, right? Maybe it will go inside the tubes. And if it go inside the tubes, then it has chance to be fertilized, right? And then move to the uterus and implant itself. But if it stays inside the peritoneal cavity, it probably will be just resorb, or sometimes it might result in a pregnancy that we call ectopic pregnancies. Some pregnancies can happen inside the tube. That's the most common ectopic pregnancies. But sometimes pregnancy can happen even, you know, inside the abdominal cavity. But for that reason, oocytes need to go in, be fertilized, and go out again. But that's a very rare case. Okay, anyway, what we're trying to say, right, and make point that ovaries and uterine tubes, they're not physically connected with one another. So now uterine tubes, also called fallopian tubes or oviduct, receive ovulated oocyte and are usual site of fertilization. Each tube is about 4 inches long and extends from area of ovary to the supralateral region of uterus. So that's a lateral, and superior means on the top. Region of uterine tube, we have isthmus, and isthmus is this constricted area where tube joins uterus, ampulla, distal end of tube that curves around ovary, infundibulum, that's expansion near ovary, and infundibulum contains fimbria. And fimbria are finger-like projections that can actually move, right, form this movement of the fluids, and hopefully pick up the ovum and move it inside the tube. Right, so ciliated fimbria that creates current to move oocyte into uterine tube. So on this diagram, you can see that's uterus, that's a uterine or fallopian tube, right? And here's our fimbria, and white structure shown here is ovary. And on this side, on your right side, you also can see ovary, but it's a cross section of ovary. So you can see the follicle and corpus luteum over here, right? And here even ovulation happened in this point, right? And this fimbria creates a current to move this ovum inside the tube. So uterus. Uterus is hollow, thick-walled muscular organ. Function is to receive, retain, and nourish fertilized ovum. So here's the uterus, and what's shown here in green are uterine tubes, right? So when oocytes is ovulated, and if it's fertilized here inside the tube, it can move toward the uterus, and this is where the embryo will develop. Position of uterus, it can be antiverted and retroverted. Antiverted, inclined forward, so that's a normal position. Let me take maybe a pink color over here. So this one. Right here, this is antiverted position. So that's a normal position, and retroverted will be this one, right? Or retroverted, you know, this and that. So it can be different degree. At a different degree, and the last one that you can you see over here is prolapsed, right? When uterus actually was dislocated, it moved down inferiorly. So uterus has several regions. So here's regions of uterus: body, major portion, fundus, rounded superior region, isthmus, narrowed inferior region, cervix is a neck or outlet project into vagina, and cervical canal communicates with vagina and uterine body through external and internal os. And next slide, I will show you all these parts. Maybe next slide, sorry. And then mesometrium is lateral, so this is support of the uterus, ligaments. Mesometrium, part of the broad ligaments that support uterus. Cardinal ligament from cervix and superior vagina to pelvic lateral wall. Uterus sacral ligament, secure uterus to sacrum. And round ligament extends through the lateral margins of the uterus through inguinal canal to external genitalia. Okay, so don't worry, we're gonna have a picture right now. On this diagram, what's shown here in green, this is called a broad ligament. So that's the modification of peritoneum that holds everything in place, right? And on the next slide, we will see parts of this broad ligament and also parts of the uterus. Okay, so here on a uterus, you can see fundus of uterus. So this is this rounded part on the top. In the middle is the body of the uterus. And this part is neck or cervix. Here's the cervix. Oops, sorry. And cervix has two openings, like this opening over here, that allows cervix to communicate with vagina, is called external os, and this opening, right, more superiorly located is internal os. So external os, internal os, and inside is cervical canal, right? Now, this blue part is broad ligament, and so this is ovarian ligament, holds ovary attached to the uterus. This ligament over here is called suspensory ligament, and inside suspensory ligament we have ovarian artery and vein and nerves. Part of the broad ligament, there are three parts: mesometrium, mesovarium, and mesosalpinx. So over here. So this one is called uterosacral ligament, right? This blue part. Right, this part that holds vagina in place, this is called cardinal ligament. Right here. And round ligament is this one over here. And round ligament, it actually leaves the body cavity, right? And through inguinal canal, it moves and connects to the external genitalia. So on this diagram, you can see also that's our round ligament, right? So it's gonna move through inguinal canal and it goes to this external genitalia over here. And on the posterior side, this ligament right over here is called uterosacral because it's connect uterus to the sacrum. So uterine wall, picking up my pointer. So uterine wall has three layers. Perimetrium is outermost layer and it's a visceral peritoneum. Myometrium, bulky middle layer consisting of smooth muscle, and endometrium, it's a inner lining and it's mucosal lining. It's made of simple columnar epithelium on the top of very thick lamina propria, and lamina propria is connective tissue. So fertilized egg burrows itself into endometrium and resides there during development. So this histological slide of the uterine wall show you the most superficial layer, perimetrium. Then this thick muscular layer is myometrium, and myo means muscle. And inside, pretty big layer of endometrium. And endometrium itself is divided into functional endometrium and basal endometrium or basalis. And this is the one that has simple cuboidal epithelium and connective tissue, loose connective tissue over here that is called lamina propria. So endometrium has two chief layers, so stratum, stratum functionalis or functional layer. And this is the one that changes every month in the response to ovarian hormone cycle. And this is the one that's shed during menstruation. And stratum basalis or basal layer, this one does not respond to ovarian hormones and it stays, right? It's not shed. And what it does, it forms new stratum functionalis after menstruation. So again, this histological slide focusing on our endometrium. So that's all endometrium. It has some glands over here, right? So all this stuff here are uterine glands, and epithelium is on the surface. So stratum functionalis, this is the one that will be shed during menstruation, and then stratum basalis will form a new stratum functionalis. Uterine arteries arise from internal iliacs and branch into arcuate arteries in myometrium, and then radial arteries, and radial arteries branch into straight arteries and spiral arteries. So straight arteries in the stratum basalis and spiral arteries in the stratum functionalis. So during menstruation, the spasm causes shedding of the functionalis, and with the functionalis, the spiral arteries are also pretty much damaged, and that's what bleeding is. When the walls are ruptured of the spiral arteries and they shed off, we're not only losing the layer of tissue, but also losing blood. So you can see that the uterine artery, then it branches into arcuate artery, and then they have radial arteries here, right? And that's a spiral arteries. This yellow part, this is the uterine gland. Now, vagina is thin walled tube, 8-10 centimeters long, that is 3-4 inches in length, and function as birth canal, passageway for menstrual flow, and organ of copulation. Vagina extends between bladder and rectum from cervix to exterior, and urethra runs parallel to vagina in front of it, right, anteriorly. So this is our last slide. We just want to look at the location of vagina. So that's a vagina. And vagina is posterior to the urethra because that's the front over here. So that's urethra, that's vagina, and posterior to vagina is rectum. So vagina is between rectum and urethra. And vagina begins from the cervix of the uterus and up to the opening, external opening, vaginal opening over here. Right, so that's it for this video, and I will continue this chapter in our next video where we will talk about external genitalia. I hope it was helpful.